tonight is sponsored by my dear friend, Mr. Jack Shaloh, in honor of his wife and his children, and also for a special kid, Benny Nahum. May he should have a lot of success, and Jack should have a lot of nachat from all his children, Bezat Hashem, Amen. Our parasha is Parashat Mishpatim. Ve'ele ha-mishpatim asher tasim lifnehem. This is the first parasha after Matan Torah. The simple meaning of Ve'ele ha-mishpatim, Hashem is telling Moshe Rabbeinu, this is the laws that you should give over to Am Yisrael. However, if we open the Zohar in our parasha, the Zohar of our parasha has a different explanation. And I would like to read it inside. The Zohar is, it's in Mamash, in the beginning of our parasha. And he says kach, the following. Patach Rabbi Shimon ve'amar. Ve'ele ha-mishpatim. What is ve'ele ha-mishpatim? Ilen Inun Sidurin de Gilgula. The Zohar talks about the Gilgul, incarnations. The Zohar talks about Ve'ele ha-mishpatim asher tasim lifnehem. Ele ha-mishpatim, the judgment, the dinim. Meaning the simple pshat, mishpat means laws. But here the Zohar says something else. Mishpat means it's not the halakha. It talks the mishpatim, the judgment that happened up there in heaven. And asher tasim lifnehem, ela mishpatim, the punishment and the judgment that people get to come back again to the world. So he has a different explanation. Not ve'ela mishpatim halachot, rather, Mishpat means judgment, and it goes back to Shamayim, Hamishpatim, people that get judged, and they have to come back to the world. It's called Gilgul, Torata Gilgulim. The incarnations, what goes out in people's life. And I want to start today with a beautiful story. And I'm giving the story because I want to give it to Benny Nahum. There is a famous story about the Baal Shem Tov. It was a very wealthy person that he had to travel far away. And before he traveled, he had a lot of money. And he was afraid to leave the money in his house. So, he had a very good friend, Ani, a poor guy, he had no money, but he was very close with him, he was a very good friend of him. So he went to him and he asked him, would you mind, I'm going away, I'll be out for a couple weeks, 7-8 weeks, I have money, I don't want to leave my money in the house, would you mind to keep my money? I'll give you the money and keep it till I come back. Amar, he told him, my dear friend, you have no problem. It's my privilege to help you. And this fellow Jew, this rich guy, he took the money, he put it in a nice bag. He came to his friend and he put it by his house. The Ani, the poor guy, took this bag, and he hides it in a place that no one should know. At the end of the day, he has to watch over someone's money, which that's what he did. Okay. The rich person, he traveled, he went for business, and he stayed there for extra weeks. And meanwhile, something happened to the Ani, to the poor guy, and he became ill. Very ill, and it came to a point that He died. He died. He died. And the kids, after the father's funeral, they came home, they said Shiva. And after the Shiva, whatever they had in their house, they, you know, the Yerusha, they gave it over. Each one took his portion. But as they were cleaning the house, and they tried to organize this whole house, they found this money, a lot of money. And the kids wondered, what? Our father had so much money and he kept quiet. I guess my father was a little stingy. No one knew about it. But now that he left so much money, now we could have a better life. And that's exactly what they did. They took the money and they split the money between the brothers, and each one went and bought a house, and they became rich people, but they got to live a very nice life. 3 months after, this fellow Jew, the rich guy, comes back and he finds out that the Ani, his friend, he passed away. He was very sad. But the sad part was, he found out that the kids became rich overnight. And everybody in town was surprised. Everybody knew that that person had no money. And since when he has money, since when he left money to his kids, and all his kids became overnight rich, it just doesn't make sense. But nobody had any clue. But we don't ask questions. The rich guy comes to the city and he finds out that the kids have the money and the bought houses. He got very mad. He went to the kids and he tell the kids, Aboisai, I gave your father money before I left for three or four months. And your father died. And I left him my money, you know, in a bag. And I assume you guys found it, but it's my money. They tell him, listen, sir, we don't know you. We don't know anything about this story. We never heard anything about this story. Sorry, we don't owe you a penny. This fellow Jew got very, very mad. And he took them to the court. He took them to the rabbinical court, to the Beit Din. He goes to Beit Din. He claims to the Dayanim, to the judges, Your Honor, I had money before I traveled. I gave the money to my friend. I knew I'm going away for a couple of good weeks and I was afraid that I'm going to lose my money. I gave my money to my friend, which happens to be he passed away. I came back and I hear that overnight his kids became rich. But the truth is, it's my money. The Dayanim open Shulchan Aruch. What's the halakha? Halakha is that if somebody claims against you that money that you have or whatever your father had and you know it's yours, and somebody comes and claims against you, halakha says shehayorshin yishav'u, let the kids swear in the betin in the rabbinical court that we have nothing what to do with any pikadon. We have no idea. We never heard. Our father, he never told us anything about it. And if the kids are willing to do such a shavua, they're going to swear in Beit Din, it's not a joke. You hold a Sefer Torah. It's dangerous. Because Chas v'Shalom, you lie, you're going to pay a heavy price. You could die. Something could happen to you. People usually stay away. People usually would pay the money and would not make a swear. And Hashem lo yishav'u. In our case, the kids, they knew 100%. Our father never told us anything. We never heard anything about it. We never heard that this man gave our father money to keep. We never heard. So they went to the Beit Din. They came to the Beit Din. The judges told them, if you are 100% right, that nothing, that you guys have no idea what happened before, well, you guys are going to have to swear. And that's exactly what happened. The kids had bitahon. They knew that they did not do anything wrong. Benishbe'u. They swear in Beit Din that they have nothing what to do with this man. Halakha is the case dismissed. The case is dismissed. And the rich guy left Bedin very, very upset. This is the halakha. This is the halakha. Although everybody in town were talking about it, it just doesn't make sense that these people became rich overnight. And it makes so much sense that this person lost his money. It happened exactly when he left. And whatever he says, it seems like he is right. But there is no evidence. There is no witnesses. There is no shtar. There is no signatures. He has no claim against the children. He left the bedin. But that story just spread it out, you know, spread around the cities. And that story got to one of the Baal Shem Tov students. And when he heard that story, it bothered him so much. At the end of the day, it says in the Torah, Derecheha Derche Noam. The Torah is pleasant. The Torah, it brings peace. How in the world somebody could, it's so obvious that he, you know, that's his money and he lost everything. It just doesn't make sense. And he went to the Baal Shem Tov, his rabbi, and he told him, Rabbi, something is bothering me. He tells him, what happened to you? So he tells him, Rabbi, this and this happened next town, next to us. And I wonder, how come this rich guy lost his money if it says Derecheha Derche Noam, V'chol Netivoteha Shalom, Torah brings peace. It seems there is no peace here. It seems there is no Noam, there is no joy, there is no pleasant here. I don't get it. Rabbi, can you explain me how is this works over here? He tells him, my dear student, you want to know? He said, yes, please, Rabbi. He tells him, tomorrow morning, after Shaharit, I want you to walk. He gives him an address. There is a spring of water, a well. Next to the well, there is a big tree with a long branches and leaves. He tells him, I want you to go to that well, climb up the tree, and I want you to sit there, make sure that you're covered with all the leaves. No one sees you. Sit on that tree. Make sure no one sees you. Stay there for a couple good hours and come to me right after. All right. The student, he woke up in the morning. He went to shul. He went to pray shaharit. He's done with, you know, pat shaharit. He had his breakfast. The rabbi told him, I have to go to this well, to that tree. He went and he sat there. And he sat on the tree. He sits on the tree. It's very hot outside. But the rabbi said, if I want to know what happened with this person, I have no question. If that's what the rabbi tells me to do, I'm going. I'm sitting here and I want to know what's going to happen. Remember, he came to the Baal Shem Tov with a question, why is this wealthy person lost his money? It seems that it's not right. Fine, what happens? A boy say, listen what happens. The Baal Shem Tov students, he climbs up the tree and he sits on the tree. And 2-3 hours after, he sees someone riding on a horse. Riding on a horse, and the horse is running, and he stopped right by the well. He was very, very thirsty. So he went, he took water, he drank the water, and then he went to take a little nap under the tree. He put his head down, he falls asleep, and after 30 minutes, he wakes up and he left. But before he left, he did not realize that his wallet dropped down from his pocket. He dropped his wallet and he left. The Baal Shem Tov student, he sits on this tree and he's not moving. The rabbi said, you gotta be there till the end of the day. Fine. An hour later, somebody else comes with a horse. Also, but this guy is not like the first one. The first one was very rich. And he lost a wallet with a lot of money. The second person who came, it was a bigger, he was a businessman. It was a regular businessman. He comes with his horse, he comes to the well, he drinks water, and he comes to take a nap. He comes to take a, you know, a little nap. He sees the wallet. Whoa! He sees a wallet with a lot of money. He grabbed the bag and, whoa, he ran away. So no one comes after him. He runs away. He runs away. 30 minutes after, a third person comes. Ani, a poor guy, has no money. Hasid, he has nothing. And he comes to drink water. He comes to drink water and he goes to take a nap. Meanwhile, the rich guy that lost his money, after an hour or two, he checks his pocket, he sees, I lost my wallet. Where's my wallet? He checks around, he opens his bags, it's not there. And he tries to recall, where is my bag? Where is my wallet? So the only thing he says to himself, the only chance that I have, maybe I dropped it by the well. So let me run back. He takes his horse, he makes a U-turn, and he runs fast, fast, fast to get to the well so nobody should steal it. He comes to the well, and sure enough, he sees a poor guy sleeping next to the well, exactly where he said, you know, an hour ago. He came to him, you, where's my money? He wakes up, what are you talking about? He starts to beat him up, he bangs him, and he starts to beating him up, and the guy is screaming, he's yelling, what do you want from me? I don't know you, you're a thief. You ganav, where is my money? This guy doesn't know what he wants. And he was beating him up. And the guy is screaming, leave me alone. Till the guy sees that if he's not going to run away, the guy's going to kill him. He ran away. The rich guy that lost his money, he was very upset. How come? I guess this guy, maybe it's not him. Maybe I did a mistake, maybe it's not him. But meanwhile, the guy got beat up. And he left very, very upset. By now, the student on top of the tree, that he saw all the story, he was, wow, what's going on over here? The first person, which he was the rich, he lost his money. The second guy came, he took the money. The third person, he got beat up for nothing, for not taking the money. Okay, now I got to go to the rabbi. He comes back and he goes to the Baal Shem Tov. He tells him, Rabbi, I want to tell you what I saw today, something crazy. I did listen to you. I did went to the well and I went up the tree. But what I saw, something that doesn't make no sense, Rabbi. He tells him what happened. He tells him, Rabbi, I saw the first person comes. He drank water. He dropped his money and he left. A second guy comes, he picks up the money, and he left. A third person comes, he drinks, he goes, he takes a nap. The rich guy comes back, he starts to beat him up, and the guy ran away. What's going on over here? Tells him, my dear, sit down and let me explain you. Tells him, yeah, Rabbi. Omar Baal Shem Tov, I want to tell you something. You should know that those three guys, they came back to the world for something that happened in the previous life. Meaning they came back by Gilgul. He tells him, Rabbi, what do you mean? He tells him, I want to tell you the story. This is the real story, he tells him. In the previous Gilgul, in the previous life, the first person, the Ashir, that lost his money, I want to tell you what happened. This guy, he took money, and what he did, he took the money from somebody, and he never returned back to him. His friend took him to Bedin. His friend took him to the Dayan, to the judge, and he told the judge, Your Honor, Rabbi, this guy, I gave him money, and he never gave it back to me. The rabbi asked the rich, the guy who got the money, Did he ever give you money? Rabbi, I have no idea what is this guy is talking about. He talks nonsense. I don't know him, Michlal. Okay? If that's what you claim, you're going to have to swear. The Baal Shem Tov tells his student that this guy that took the money, he made a swear, but he was a lie. He lied. So now watch this. So he made money. The other person that the money was, you know, belonged to him, he lost his money. He told them, they both came back to the world. Those two people, they came back to the world. That person who made the money, who took the money back then, that's the first person, that's the rich guy who came to the well and he dropped his wallet. That money that he dropped, that's the money that he took back then in the previous life. Wow. Rabbi, and who's the second person? The second person, that's the person who he took away from him and now he gets it back. So wow, Rabbi, that's a crazy, wait. So now I know why, what happened to the first and the second. But one thing I don't get, why the poor guy got beat up? He was the judge, he was the Dayan. Waya Dayan, instead of taking this case, investigate or try to settle it, to compromise something between them, according to the halakha, he didn't care. You didn't care? That's why the first person, the Ashir, came, he beat him up. You know why? You know why he beat him up? Because of you, we all three came back. You should have done a better job. Because of you, I lost. Because of you, I had to come back. And because of you, this guy came back also. That's why he got beat up. Omelo Baal Shem Tov. That's the pshat shema shekatu bezohar. Ve'ele ha-mishpatim asher tasim lifneihem. Ma'amer ha-zohar. Ilen inun sidurin de gilgula. Dinin de nishmatin. De'itdanu kol had ve'had lekabel onsheh. These are the laws that you should set before them. That's the pshat. But the way the Zohar HaKadosh explains, he says, Ela mishpatim, the judgment. Why people come back to the world. And this is the pshat omer lo Baal Shem Tov. If you see something, it's because it has to do with, if it doesn't make sense now, you got to track what happened before he came to the world. Ela mishpatim, mishpatim means judgment. Haverim Ekarim, meaning from here we learn that if we see things in our life, and things doesn't make sense, make sure and be sure it has to do something that nothing to do with this life. It goes back to something before. My Rabbi Alav Shalom, I remember he told me about 22 years ago, I was by him, by Leila Seder. As we had the Leila Seder together, he told me, Rabbi Yonatan, I want to share with you a story. Say, Rabbi, which story? He tells me that 40 years ago, meaning almost 60 years ago, his family, they were doing Leila Seder in Yerushalayim. And all of a sudden, a black dog came to the door. He was sitting down the whole Leila Seder. He was sitting down, you know, they tried to kiss him, he sits there, he doesn't move. Okay. After Leila Seder was over, the dog left. All right, fine, it happens. He says, the next year, the same dog came back during Leila Seder, and he sat down by the door, he's not moving. So they told the rabbi, what's going on over here? So they said, give him matzah to eat. They gave the dog matzah to eat. He left, he never came back. You hear this? When you see stories that just doesn't make sense, it has to do with Gilgulim that we don't understand. Whether it's for good or for bad, either way. זה מה שאומר הזוהר הקדוש, ואלה המשפטים, משפטים means judgment. We don't understand how Hashem runs the world, but everything has a reason. Okay, עד כאן הקפה הראשונה. I want to continue. אומר הכלי יקר, ואלה המשפטים אשר תשים לפניהם. מה זה לפניהם? אומר הכלי יקר, לפני המצוות שבין אדם למקום, make sure that you know how to behave למצוות שבין אדם לחברו. You hear this? אלה המשפטים אשר תשים לפניהם. Before the mitzvot that you carry about ben adam lamakom, ben adam lachavero, how do you behave? In our parashat mishpatim, if we could say almost the entire parashat of our, of this week, which is parashat mishpatim, all the laws, all the halachot, all the dinim, it's between ben adam lachavero. It's amazing. We just got עשרת הדיברות, we just heard Hashem's voice speaking to us, אנוכי השם אלוהיך. The first mitzvah is, לא תגנוב. The parasha talks about, כי תקנה עבד עברי, what happened to him? If a Jew stole money, and he doesn't have the money to pay back, we're going to take him, we're going to sell him as a slave. What happened? Is that the right thing to learn right after Matan Torah? Yes. That's exactly what we learn right after Matan Torah. Why is it? And the answer is, when you want to know how to get close to Hashem, make sure you have Ben Adam Lachaviro first. The Ben Adam Lachaviro, that's a key to get to the Ben Adam Lamakom. I saw a beautiful pshat in later on in the parasha. It says, although זה לא על פי הפשט, it's not according to the פשט, אבל על פי הדרש, it's a very nice פשט. בוא נראה, let's look inside. לא קרא בעל הבית אלא אלוקים. איפה זה? לא קרא. Yeah, in Perek Chaf Bet, Pasuk Zayin, it says there, "Venikav ba'al habayit el ha'elohim, im lo shalach yado b'melechet re'ehum." So I saw a pshat, "Venikav ba'al habayit." If a person is a ba'al habayit, is that a rabbi? Is not someone who learns the whole day. He's a Baal HaBayit, he's a business person, he's a businessman. V'nikra Baal HaBayit El HaElohim, someone who's a businessman and he wants to be close to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. V'nikra Baal HaBayit El HaElohim, someone who's a businessman and he wants to be close to Hashem. How can I get so, how can I be close to Hashem? The answer is, אם לא שלח ידו במלאכת רעהו. If you treat your customers honestly, אם לא שלח ידו במלאכת רעהו, if you're honest with your workers, with your customers, if you're honest with people that you get the order and you pay them on time, no monkey business. That person אומרת התורה, such a בעל הבית, ונקרב אל האלוהים. That's the way to be so close to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So going back, we just said that after Matan Torah, we're talking about the ganav, we're talking about somebody who stole money. The answer is yes, we do. You know why? Because the way to get close to HaKadosh Baruch Hu is how you're dealing with the money. If the money that you make is a kosher money, then Aseret HaDibirot has meaning. If not,
How can you get close to Hashem? How can you be so close? How can you be so close to Hashem? And that's the key. Ve'nikrav ba'al ha'bayit Elohim. Ba'al ha'bayit, a business person, a businessman. You want to be close to Hashem? The answer is be honest with your people. Be honest in business. Let's continue. Omer ha'Torah k'dusha. Omer ha'Torah k'dusha. כי תקנה עבד עברי ששנים יעבוד ובשביעית יצא לחופשי חינם. I read a beautiful story about 50 years ago, the Satmar Rebbe, Rabbeinu Yoel Misatmar, in this week's parasha, he was in London, and they had a whole tish on Friday night, and Rabbi Yoel spoke for 4 hours. 4 hours he spoke. One of the things, one of the messages that he said, and I have it right over here, a beautiful pshat. Here's a question. You know, we have Shulchan Aruch. Here is the Shulchan Aruch. You see, this is the Shulchan Aruch. Shulchan Aruch has four parts. It's called Ora Haim, Yore De'a, Even Ha'ezer, and Hoshet Mishpat. Let me explain. Ora Haim talks about Ora Haim, how you live on a daily basis. Meaning it talks about the laws of Tefillah, Tzitzit, Brachot, Shabbat, holidays. That's Ora Haim. Then we have Yore Da'a, that's Ilchot Shechita, how to kosher a meat, Dine Nida, Dine Ribit, you have Dine Nedarim, Ve'od. Then you have Dine Even Ha'ezer. Even Ha'ezer are the laws of marriage, divorce, Ketubah, Yerusha, V'chul, Ilchot Ishut. And then we have Hoshen Mishpat. Hoshen Mishpat are the halachot that has to do with money. Dine mamonot, that's beddin. It seems like our parasha, if we have the four sections, we have Ora Haim, we have Yore Da'a, we have Even Ha'ezer, and we have Hoshen Mishpat. From all these four, which one the Torah starts with? Our parasha, it seems, the Torah starts with Hoshen Mishpat, correct? Hoshen Mishpat. So Rabbeinu Yoel had a question. How come, if right after Matan Torah, the section that was given to Am Yisrael was Hoshen Mishpat, why, how come Bet Yosef, when he wrote the Shulchan Aruch and he wrote all the halachot of the Torah, kula, of the whole Torah, how come he puts that section at the end? And he starts with the halachot of Ora Haim. Why does he start with the halachot of tefillin and prayers and Shabbat and holidays? Just follow the Torah. The first things, the first halachot that we learn now, parasha, it's money. If it's money, it should be first Hoshen Mishpat. How come it's Ora Haim? That's his question. And he says a beautiful pshat. Why and how come the Beit Yosef starts with Ora Haim and not with Ilchot Hoshen Mishpat. Why? In the beginning of Hoshen Mishpat, in Siman Yud Bet, Maran says the following. It says kacha. Mitzvah lomar leba'ale dinim batehila, hadin atem rotzim o apeshara. When two people come to Beit Din, the first thing that the judges ask the people, what do you want? You want us to judge you, or you want us to make peshara, to compromise things together? What do you rather? Omer Shulchan Aruch, V'chol Beit Din she'oseh peshara tamid, hare ze meshubah. The best thing is don't give judgment, don't give verdict, don't. Try to compromise, because when you compromise, they're both happy. When you give the din, one feels I lost, and the other one walks out happy. Or both said, okay? But in any event, when you do peshara, when you compromise, they're both happy, and it's a good thing, and it's a great thing. Why? Emet u'mishpat shalom shiftu b'sha'arechem. How can you bring mishpat that has peace? It's only if you do peshara. Meaning, you get 50 and you get 50. Or you don't pay him the whole thing and you just take only 50. Meaning, Hoshen Mishpat starts that, you know what's the best thing in life to do? Always try to do peshara. Try to compromise. Don't do all the way alpi halacha. Try to compromise. Omer Rabbeinu Yoel Misatmer, imagine we're going to start Shulchan Aruch with this message. Do you know what's good in the Jewish law? Always try to compromise. Guess what? Once I know this halakha, that pshara is tov, people will take this halakha and they're going to use it in the entire Shulchan Aruch. It's going to come shaharit in the morning. You're going to wake up. It's okay. We just learned peshara is the best thing to do. Peshara means I could pray at home. I don't have to go to shul. What about Kriyat Shema? You know, I'll do it after, you know, midday. Kriyat Shema bizmana. It's okay. Don't be so strict. You got to learn to do pesharot in life. And then it comes Ilchot Shabbat. And then it comes Ilchot Mo'adim. And then it comes Ilchot Nida. And then it comes Ilchot Kashrut. If everything you're going to learn peshara, you're going to compromise, you're not going to keep any halachot. That's why Omer Rabbeinu Yoel, what do? No. First, let me teach you Ora Chaim. And then Yore De'ah. And then Even Ezer. At the end, we're going to teach you that compromise is a good thing. Only in Beddin. Don't take this halakha of peshara, of to compromise, in all the Jewish laws. That's not how we do. That's why he says, that's the reason why the Shulchan Aruch did not start his book with Hoshen Mishpat. Peshara, it's only when it comes between you and your friend money, not between you and Avodat Hashem. That's wrong. And Haverim Ekarim, let's continue on the old Nekudah of Farah Parashah, another beautiful Nekudah. The Torah tells us that if somebody stole money, he has no money to pay back, so Ma'amal Simlo, he's going to have to pay back. He doesn't have to pay back. Bittin is going to take him. We're going to sell him as a slave to a Jewish owner, not a goy. We will never sell a Jew to a goy, ever. A soul. So, we're going to sell this fellow Jew, and he becomes a slave. How long? The max is 6 years. After 6 years, comes the Shemitah. He's free to go home. Here comes the slave, the Eved Ivri, and the Torah tells us, Pasuk he, Perek Chaf Aleph, Pasuk he, V'im Amor Yomar Ha'Eved, Ahavti et Adoni, et Ishti ve'et Banai, Lo Yetze Chofshi. What if, after 6 years, the slave says to the Beddin, Ahavti et Adoni, I love my master, I'm very happy here, I don't want to go home. Halacha says, "V'gisho Adonav el Elohim, v'gisho el Adelet o el Mezuzam, v'ratza Adonav et Ozno b'Marzeya va'avado le'olam." We take this slave, we take him to the door, to the doorpost, and we're gonna pierce his ear. V'ratza Adonav et Ozno b'Marzeya. Is going to be his slave till the Yovel for 50 years. 50 years, Ada Yovel is going to be his slave. So he's going to stay with a hole that pierces his ear. Fine. A boy say, the Kli Aka has a question. Why do we take him to the door? Why do we take him to the door? You know, when parents take the kids, the babies,
the baby girl, right? To have her earrings, you go to the store, they have this little machine, tuck, that's it. You don't take it to the door and you make a hole over there, right? So the cracker asks, why is it that we have to take the Jewish slave to the doorpost to make a hole by the door? Why? Omer Kliyaka, one, because we opened the door for you to let you go home. We opened the door for you to let you go. And you said, no, I want to stay here. Wait, I'm giving you an option to go home. Be independent. Be a normal Jew. Be a slave to Hashem. So the door is open and you stayed here? You know, it's like someone who did a crime and he got jailed for 13 years. After 6 years, they come down to the jail. They tell him, Benjamin, listen, the door is open. You can go home. He says, no, I'm staying here. What? The door is open and you're staying here? That means you're a dib. You're not a smart man. For that, we're going to punish you. Omeret HaTorah, we opened the door for you to leave, to go back. Go back to your wife. You want to stay here? On this door that we opened the door for you, and you said, no, I'm staying here. On this door, we're going to make you, we're going to pierce your ear. That's one nekuda. And why O'el HaMezuzah? Very simple, Omeret HaKliyakar. If you open the mezuzah, after the pasuk of Shema Yisrael, what's the next line? Ve'ahavta et Hashem Elohecha. You have a mitzvah to love Hashem. Instead, ma hu amar? Im amor yomar ha'eved ahavti et Adoni. I love my master, basar v'adam. Human being, instead of Hashem, instead of loving Hashem, you're loving basar v'adam? For that, we're going to pierce your ear. One, because we let the door open for you and you did not leave. Second, by the mezuzah, it says, "Ahavta et Hashem Elohecha." Instead, he says, "Ahavti et Adoni." Gevaldik, yafeh mod. Let's continue, Haverim Ekarim. Another beautiful, I saw a beautiful pshat. Such a beautiful pshat. It says, Halakha says, if somebody went to his friend, Perek Chavbet, Pasuk, Yud Gimel, Yud Dalet, Bechi Ish'al Ish Me'im Re'ehu, if somebody asked his friend, can you lend me your car? And it broke. He gave him the car, and it broke. What's the halakha? Do you have to pay? Huh? The halakha says, shalem yeshalem. He has to pay. But, im be'alav imo, imagine, your friend said, I'm willing to give you my car. You went down to your friend's house. You took the car. While you were in the car, the owner of the car, your friend, was with you. And the car broke down. What's the halakha? Do you have to pay or you don't have to pay? The Torah says, Im ba'alav imo lo yeshalim. You hear this? Again, if you went to your friend and you ask your friend, can you please lend me your car? He gave you his car. You came home, after 2 days, it broke. You gotta pay. But the Torah says, if the car broke down, while the owner of the car, your friend, was there, you don't have to pay. That's the halakha. Haverim Mekarim, I saw something, it was such a, you know, when I read it, I just felt so great.
when I read this pshat. I read, Ronnie, you're going to listen to this. Alan, listen to this one. This is a beautiful pshat. Mashu Matok, Ariel, listen to this. Jackie, that's for sure for you. You're going to love it. Tomer, Pashut Mod. Take it and sell it. He says, V'chi yish'al ish me'im ra'ehu. V'nishbar. Kadosh Baruch Hu. He is called our Re'ah, our friend. V'chi yish'al ish me'im ra'ehu. We ask Hashem, we need money. We need house. We need health. We need wealth. Hashem gives us everything. And what happens? Then nishbar. And we do sin. And we do sin. Each one knows what he has to fix about. We all need to fix ourselves. What's the halakha? Halakha is you gotta pay. Oh, shalem yeshalem. You gotta pay. Oh, yo, you gotta pay. You gotta pay double. Shalem yeshalem. For avirot, there is no free to go. You gotta pay. However, im be'alav imo. Sometimes we, as people, as the Jew, as Jews, we do the sin. But as we do the sin, we feel guilt. I know I'm not good. I know what I'm doing is wrong. I don't want to do it. But the Yetzer Hara killed me. He won. I had this desire and I fell in a big sin and I feel bad. I was able to eat kosher and I did it. I messed up and I feel so bad. You know you do bad. You feel bad that you did something wrong because you know Hashem is with me. How can I do this? I don't deny that Hashem sees me. I know He sees me. Omeret HaTorah, oh, im ba'alav emo, if while you do the sin you feel guilt, lo yishalem. You hear this? You hear this? It's a beautiful pshat. Ach, when I saw this pshat, it just gives motivation. We have hope. We still have hope. You know why? Ba'alav imo. Shiviti Hashem l'negdi tamid. Yeah, but I failed. Don't worry. Omer the Torah, ba'alav imo lo yishalem. If you did this sin and you denied that, I don't believe in Hashem, you do whatever you want, you're a dib. You know why? Shalem yishalem. You're gonna pay double. Dir Balak. But if you don't deny Hashem, you know Hashem exists, and you know He sees you, and you know what you did, I was wrong. But what can I do, Hashem? I failed. Please, Hashem, forgive me. Amir Hashem, ba'alav imo, lo yishalem. I'm telling you, when I saw this, what do you feel? Givaldik. Tomer says Givaldik. Jackie, I know you're in heaven. Baruch Hashem, that's good. That's a good shot. That's a good pshat. Rabbi, Namshich Hala. Let's continue. Parasha has so many good things. Omeret HaTorah in Perek Chavbet Pasuk Chav Aleph. Kol almana ve'yatom lo ta'anun. A widow and an orphan. Omeret Hashem, Omeret the Torah says, be very careful with them. Why? Ki im ane ta'ane oto. If you're going to torture him. If he's going to scream to me, I'm going to hear his yell, his screaming. I'll be very angry. I will kill you. You caused an orphan to cry. You caused him pain. And then he came to me to Hashem and he was crying and screaming to me. Boy, I will punish you. I'm going to take you and your wife. She's going to become almana. And your kids are going to become orphans. Yetomim. I saw a question. Why is it that this love is any different than any other lavim. We have so many lav, don't do. Why specifically this lav, the Torah says, I'm going to kill you. Why? Question number one. Question number two. Why everything is doubled? You see this? Pasuk Chav Bet, Haverim. Im ane, ta'ane oto. Ki im tsa'ok, itzak. Shamoa, eshma. Why is it that the words over here are doubled? Ane, ta'ane, tsa'ok, itzak, shamoa, eshma. Meaning, if you're going to torture him, it says twice. Tsa'ok is going to yell, it says twice. Shamoa, eshma, I will hear him twice. Why is it? So I saw a Psat Kacha. It brought down in a Hoveret. It's called Torah Mitzion Shana Dalet. He brings out a beautiful Pshat. Omer Kach. Says, if you do it once, then you're going to get punished as a regular love. You can get lashes. It can be a Malkot. Meaning, you caused him, you tortured him once, he screamed once, and I heard once. In such a case, you get punished, malkot. But if you did it over again, ane ta'ane, you did twice, tsa'ok itzak, you caused him to scream twice, Shamoa Eshma. I heard the first time I heard it already. And I gave you no. Again, if I can hear twice, then what happens? Omeret haTorah v'hara api v'harakti etchem b'harev. Omeret, the Torah says how we gotta be so careful with orphans and widows. The Ramban brings down Almana, it's even Almana shel Melech. Even a queen. The king died, and the queen stayed, you know, and the queen left alone. She is called Almana. Even her, you got to be very careful. Why? Shedimata metzuya. The tear is very likely to come down. Very fast, and we got to be very careful. Aval Havarim, you should know that this halakha is not only almana and yatom. It's not true. It's not only almana and yatom. This halakha applies also to people that they are alone, and they're very easy to cry because of whatever situation they have, and you're not sensitive to their feelings. You gotta be very, very careful. צריך מאוד, מאוד, מאוד להיזהר. Let's continue. אומרת לנו התורה, פסוק כ"ד, אם כסף תלווה את עמי, את העני עמך. אומרת התורה, אם מצווה to lend money to a poor person. He asked, can you please lend me, I need $2,000. If you please lend me, I'll give you in 90 days. If you have a mitzvah to give. Yeah, but make sure that he has a way to pay you back. If he has no way to pay you back, you have no mitzvah to give him. There is no mitzvah to give. There is no mitzvah to lend a friend or somebody money if he doesn't have a way to pay you back. At the end of the day, not only that you're not going to back your that you're not going to get your money back, You're causing him a sin because he's not going to pay you. So what are you doing? Don't give him. Rather, he came to you, he asked you for $2,000. I'd rather give him $500 a gift than losing $2,000. It's wrong. Anyway, חברים יקרים, תשמעו מה כתוב. כתוב פה, אם כסף תלווה את עמי. אומר הספר מנחה בלולה ככה, אם כסף תלווה את עמי, if you have money, and your friend has a way to pay you back the money. Im kesef talve et ami, if you're gonna lend money, then fine. Vim lav, you have money. You can lend your friend's money, and he'll pay you back. And you don't want to pay him. Omer et haTorah, be careful. You know why? Ha'ani imach. You're going to end up becoming ani. If you have the money, and he has a way to pay you back, and is asking you, I just need for 90 days. Can you please give me money? I just need to marry my daughter. I just need to, you know, a couple, I need 5,000. Can you lend me? Give it to him. Do a great mitzvah. Why? Lama. Omeret haTorah, im kesef talve et ami. That's fine. Ve'im lav. Ha'ani imach. You're going to end up becoming ani. Haram. Do you want to lose money? No. So give. That's one beautiful pshat. Aval Rabbo Yisai, Omer ha'alshech ha'kedosh, davar nifla. Omer ha'alshech kacha. Im kesef talve et ami, et ha'ani imach. Ma kavana? I was sitting down with my friend, and I asked him a simple question. If I have, Tomer, let me ask you a question. If I have $500, okay? I took $300, I put it in tzedakah. How much do I have left? $200. Let's do again. I have $500, I put $300 in tzedakah. כמה נשאר? Again. I have 500. I gave 300 to tzedakah. How much I left with?
200. 300.
Oh, that's it. That's the answer. If I have 500, I give 300 to tzedakah. How much I have left? I have left 300. Because the 200 you're going to spend is on something else. What I invest, that what I'm going to take with me up there in heaven. Omer ha'alshech ha'kedosh, kacha, lifnei ha'alshech, im kesef talve et ami, if you're going to lend your friend money, that tzedakah et ha'ani, the tzedakah that you give to the ani, imach, et ha'ani imach, that money is going to stay with you forever. אומר הארשך הקדוש, יש פסוק שכתוב, הון ועושר בביתו, וצדקתו עומדת לעד. So the הארשך הקדוש explains, הון ועושר בביתו. People, we have money. Some, צדקה, the rest he left over here. אומר שתומו, אומר ככה. אומר הוא ככה, הון ועושר בביתו. All his money he left in his house. Hon ve'osher beveto. The money that he left it here in his house. Ve'tzidkato. The tzedakah that he gave, omedet la'ad. It stays by him, le'olmei olamim, forever. So, what should you do? Kesef telve et ami. If you have money that you can do tzedakah with this, do. Why? Et ha'ani imach. This is what's going to go with you up there, to Shamayim. Omer al-Sheikh, I want to add a beautiful davar. So he says, you know what? It seems it's not fair. Comes the ani, he says, I wish I had money. I wish I had money. I wanted to give money. I can't do tzedakah. I'm a little sad. Look, my friend has money. He can do. I don't have money. What should I do? Te'uma ketuv. Omer et haTorah, in Perek Chavbet, Pasuk, Chavhet. Ketu Shama, Meleatcha v'dimacha lo ta'acher, Bechor banecha titen li. What does it mean, Bechor banecha titen li? Haverim, I want to read a couple lines from the Al-Sheikh HaKadosh. He says, V'im tomar ha'ani, if the ani is going to say, En li tevua li t'asher al ede terumot u'ma'asrot, ואוי לי על עוני כי אין מנחם לי. The ani says, look, I don't have money to give tzedakah. I wish, I want to give terumot, I want to give ma'asot, I would love to. I don't have.
אומרת התורה בפסוק חפחת, מלאתך ודמעך אל תאחר. It's a mitzvah for the עשיר, to give the מעשות on time. Don't give מעשר late. You have the מעשר, give it on time. And what, so that's the beginning of the pasuk. And the pasuk ends, בכור בנך תיתן לי. What does it mean? He says ככה, the beginning of the pasuk talks to the rich people. You have money? Give. And give on time. The end of the pasuk talks to the aniyim, to the people who have no money. Why? He explains, Omer, if you don't have money because your business is tough, you know, your business is not doing so well, and you cannot give tzedakah, you cannot give so much ma'aser, then what should you do? Omer al-Sheikh, Omer al-Sheikh, al tahush, don't worry. Shelcha gadol. You have more than them. Why? Ki bechor banecha titen li. He says, ki derech rov ha'aniim. Most people who don't have much money, what happens? Hem matzlechim bebanim. You see, they have good kids. You hear this? It's give and take. אומר בכור בנך תיתן לי. אם לא תצלח בממון, if you're not going to succeed with money, you're going to succeed with children. You're going to have good children. You're going to have children who are going to follow Hashem's ways. You're going to have people, you're going to have children that go to shul every morning. You're going to have kids that they learn Torah every day. בכור בנך תיתן לי. What happens? אומר הוא, you can have good children. Kederech rov ha'anim. Most poor people, they have good children, Amir Arab. Rov ha'anim. Most poor people, they have good kids, he says. Ve'lo titye'es min ha'mamon. Why? Because of your children, that they learn Torah, and they follow Hashem's Torah mitzvot, what happens after? תראו מה כתוב the next פסוק, פסוק חבטת, כן תעשה לשורך לצונך. You're gonna have shor, you're gonna have son, you're gonna have everything. זאת אומרת, אומר לך הרב, זה גלגל, זה גלגל. Hashem is testing you במצב שלך. Whatever you can do, do. Aboy say, I want to end up with a beautiful thing, that a beautiful pshat that has to do with kosher food. That has to do with kosher food. The Torah says in Pasuk Lamed, "Vanshe kodesh tihiyun li, ubasar basade terata lo tochelu, lakelev tashlichun oto." Torah says, if you have non-kosher food, non-kosher meat, terefa, give it to the dog, fine. But you should stay and share kodesh. The Torah calls people who eat only kosher food, the Torah calls them and share kodesh, holy people. Meaning if you don't eat kosher food, not only that you're not holy, but you're a thief. Because you're stealing the dog's food. Hashem says, I gave the dog basar terefa. What are you doing? It's not yours, it's his. What are you doing? And I want to share a story that it's brought down in Talmud Yerushalmi, Masechet Terumot, Perek Shmini, Halakha Gimel. Listen, what a story. What a story. Mashu Madim. Omer Yerushalmi, Ma'aseh betabach betzipori. It was a butcher in the city Tzipori. Tzipori is up the north. It's a city all the way up the north. So it was a butcher. Shehaya ma'achil Yisrael nevelot utrefot. Hashem yishmo. He knew that he's selling non-kosher meat. In purpose. He did it. Pa'am echad. It was one day, Erev Shabbat, it was Friday night, Shata Yain,
He was drinking wine. Venishtaker, he got drunk. Because he got so drunk, Alala Gag, he went up the roof. Venafal Vemet. Went up the roof, he fell down and he died. Vayu kelavim melakekin bedamo. Dogs came and they were licking his blood. Now, what do? A dead body on Shabbat, it's mukte. You don't touch a body, it's a mukte. Med, mukte. But from the other hand, dogs coming and they drink his blood, they're eating his body. What should we do?
Atun v'sha'alu l'Rabbi Hanina.
They came to Rabbi Hanina and they told him, Rabbi, there is a niftar over here with somebody who died. We know it's mukte. But dogs are coming and licking his blood. What should we do? Meaning, is there any heter to move his body? You hear that?
Amar lehem Rabbi Hanina. Rabbi Hanina told him, it says in the Torah, Ubasar basade terefa lo tochelu lakelev tashlichun otom. The Torah says, if you have a non-kosher meat, you should give it to the dogs. Veze haya gozel et haklavim. And this fellow Jew, he stole food from the dogs. Therefore, Amar lahem, hanichu laklavim, leave the dogs alone, ki mishelahem hem ochlim, because they eat from what belongs to them. Ugazal otam, his own body, ze hatikha terefa, so let them eat terefa. The dogs are doing fine. It's okay, don't touch the dogs. Let them eat whatever they want to eat. Haverim yekarim, Torah omeret lanu po davar gadol meod. That if you eat kosher food, your body becomes kadosh. If you don't eat kosher food, beside the sin that you have, v'ma ketupo, ata gozel et haklavim. Gozlim et haklavim. Ay, 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 ay. Gozlim et haklavim. Od davar katan, small thing. Tzerech esayem davar yafeh. We say in the Amidah every day, ha-mevarech et amo Yisrael בשלום, right? בברכת שים שלום, תרומה וברכה, חיים חן וחסד, we end up המברך את עמו ישראל בשלום. Where it says in the Torah that הקדוש ברוך הוא, he blessed עם ישראל to be in peace. איפה כתוב כזה דבר? Huh? יש פסוק בתורה שהשם ברך את עם ישראל בשלום? לא מה שאנחנו מכירים. חברים יקרים, I want to share with you beautiful מסכת דרך ארץ. It says in מסכת דרך ארץ אותה, אמר רבי יהושע, רבי יהושע says, גדול הוא השלום. Peace is a great thing. Why? בשעה שעמדו ישראל ואמרו, כל אשר דיבר אדוני נעשה ונשמע. My friends, this is the last piece, בלי נדר for the day. בלי נדר. Let's open inside. We're not going to miss this one. Let's go 24. Perek Chav Dalet Pasuk Zayin. Vayikah Sefer HaBerit. Vayikah Bozne Ha'am Vayomeru. Kol Asher Diber Adonai Na'aseh V'Nishma. Ma ketuv po? That Am Yisrael said Na'aseh V'Nishma. Omer HaMidrash. Amar Rabbi Yoshua. When Am Yisrael said Na'aseh V'Nishma. Samach ba'em ha-kadosh baruch hu. Hashem was so happy. Hashem was so proud. Ve'natan lahem torato. And Hashem gave them the Torah. U'berecham b'shalom. When Hashem gave the Torah to Am Yisrael, u'berech otam in peace. She'ne'emar, Adonai oz la'amo yiten. Adonai yivarech et amo b'shalom. Ma zeh Hashem oz la'amo yiten? Oz zeh Torah. When Hashem gave the Torah to Am Yisrael, השם בירך את עם ישראל בשלום. חברים, תראו מה זה. In which פרק it says נעשה ונשמע? ג'קי, in which פרק is it? פרק 24. Which פסוק? 7. Meaning 24-7, we say to Hashem, נעשה ונשמע. שיהיה לכם לילה טוב ושבת שלום. Remember this piece. We have 24-7. We say to Hashem, נעשה ונשמע. This is a beautiful, beautiful source. You know, they have 7-Eleven. They have all the stores. You know, it's only in America they came up with this idea of 24-7. 25 years ago, 30 years ago, I don't remember had stores 24-7 open. Lately, they got it. You know, where is the source?